Hi everyone, it would be great if you can just confirm if I'm audible and the connection is not lagging. Hi Ritika ma'am, thank you. Great. So we're actually waiting for Siley to join. So when like before she comes in, so what I can tell you all is that this live, use this if you are willing to participate in the future. Use this time to ask us all the questions you want to, because we're here. That's exactly what we're here for, is to clear out your doubts and answer any kind of questions that you would have. Also, thank you so much, everyone. So, any questions? In fact, y'all can even start asking me the questions, and we will also continue asking more questions once Siley joins in. Thank you, Chetna. How tall am I? I am 165 centimeters. Though with Miss Teen Diva, you're not gonna have a lot of problem with height per se. So even if you're a little shorter or taller, anything works. And okay, is being taller better? So now again, because the height criteria is sort of very low, and it is something, it's made for teenagers, right? So they're not expecting you to be very, very tall. And it's not a disadvantage if you're shorter. Like it's not that, oh, the tallest girl in the competition will be the one who's going to win. So it's more about how you're able to carry yourself, not necessarily like I'm not the tallest amongst everyone. However, that did not affect me winning. So yeah, it does not matter so much. Once you win the title, what is your life like? Considering you're also a teenager, do you continue your studies or is there something else that you go ahead with? Okay. So now, of course, when you get crowned, in fact, the second you get crowned is a very, very life-changing moment. However, with Miss Teen Diva, the one thing that is amazing about the organization as a whole is that they are great when it comes to cooperating. So I'm in my college first year, and whenever I have exams or very important college events, I let them know beforehand, and they make sure that they are not sort of occupying me during that amount of time. So yes, I do study and I do continue to do things. And once you sort of win, you also have to start to put your efforts into preparing for your internationals. So you have to learn how to time manage. But once you get in the chain of doing it, then it's not really that difficult. And usually schools and colleges are very cooperative with understanding the situation and will help you out in all situations. ओके सो किसी ने पूछा है कि हम मिस टीन डीवा कैसे ज्वाइन करें, तो आप मिस टीन डीवा की वेबसाइट पे जा सकते हैं जो इसी अकाउंट के बायो पर है. उस पर आप क्लिक करेंगे तो वहाँ पे आपको फॉर्म मिल जाएगा एंड यू विल हैव टू फिल द फॉर्म. उसमें कुछ डिटेल्स मांगी गई हैं, कुछ पिक्चर्स, हाइट एंड एवरीथिंग जो आपको भरना पड़ेगा. एंड उसके बाद अगर आप सिलेक्ट होते हैं या नहीं होते हैं तो मिस टीन डीवा आपको एक ईमेल भेजेगा. वॉट कैन बी द अप्रोक्स बजट फॉर मिस टीन? ओके, तो नाउ फॉर वेन मनी इज कंसर्न्ड, इट रियली डिपेंड्स फ्रॉम पर्सन टू पर्सन, बिकॉज इट डिपेंड्स ऑन हाउ वेल यू आर एबल टू सॉर्ट ऑफ मार्केट योर सेल्फ. इफ यू आर एबल टू फाइंड स्पॉन्सर्स एंड स्टफ लाइक दैट, देन ऑफकोर्स यू विल बी स्पेंडिंग प्रपोर्शनेटली लेस. बट द वन कॉस्ट दैट यू विल इनकर इज द पेजेंट फी. कीपिंग दैट असाइड, इट जेन्यूनली डिपेंड्स ऑन एवरी सिंगल पर्सन हाउ मच यू वॉन्ट टू स्पेंड. इट्स नॉट नेसेसरी टू स्पेंड लैक्स एंड लैक्स ऑफ रुपीज. यू कैन डेफिनेटली डू इट इन अ वेरी वेरी गुड बजट ऑल्सो. Hey, we have a conversation about the email credit team. Also, yes, whoever is waiting for an email, please just be a little patient. You will get your emails, so don't worry about that. what opportunities did you get? So of course now this is a national pageant, right? It's a national title that you're actually carrying onto yourself. So you're going to get a lot of opportunities. You get a lot of recognition in general. And if you are somebody who's looking at the field of modeling or pageantry, even in the future, then I can tell you this much, that you do get noticed. So keep that in mind when you're participating. And the noticing is not just for the winners. It's for literally every contestant that comes and participates, because the whole pageant is watched by hundreds and thousands of people. So if they like you, you're definitely going to get advantage out of that. How to participate in Miss Teen Diva? Again, you will find the link in the bio. So you'll be able to go ahead and apply from there. You can also find posts on Miss Teen Diva's page itself, which guide you through the application process. No reputed organization asks for so much money. That's how people know they're fake. Okay, so one way I can tell you is not fake is because I'm sitting here right in front of you. And now I do understand that paying a pageant fee can be something that's a very high cost to a lot of people. However, when you're conducting a pageant, when you're part of a pageant, when you'll go for it, you will realize that it is worth it. And I can promise you, it is not fake. It's a very, very legit organization. And they are great at what they do. And that is why I feel I'd say it's worth actually investing in it, because it is an investment and you will gain things out of it. So don't worry about it being fake or them scamming you for your money, because that is not going to happen. They're very, very genuine people, and they're very cooperative and very understanding at the same time. So now the Miss Teen Diva organization does not ask you to spend specific amount of money. Absolutely not. So it's actually personally on you as a contestant how much you would like to spend. You do get a list of things that you may require throughout, like a list of garments, your wardrobe that you would have to carry. And those things, yes, they are expensive, but if you start to sort of build them up slowly and steadily, then at the end of the day, you're not going to have to be spending a lot of money in one go. What opportunities do you get after the pageant? So now the opportunities are truly endless, and they are not limited to you just winning. Opportunities will come to literally every single girl that has been part of the national finale. So they come from all varieties. So I don't think it'll be justice for me to pinpoint one and just leave that there. Hi Rashi. So guys, we have Rashi Parasrampuria, who's also a Miss Teen International India 2021 part of this live. And yes, hi beautiful, how are you doing? Okay, so what is the pageant fee? The pageant fee for this year, for the coming pageant, is 80,000 rupees, and the pageant is also longer. It will be about 9 to 10 days long approximately, and the dates of the pageants are yet to come out. How is it a national pageant without even a normal verification on Instagram, and then winners have 2k followers and all people are more than that? Okay, so again, it's a pageant that is growing, and just because it's not verified on Instagram does not sort of question its legitimacy. It is a legit pageant. We all do have following international pageants. All four of us have following international pageants. So have trust on that. You're going to see us compete internationally. So I think that will give you the confirmation that you need to make sure that the pageant is actually real. So my name is Vachi Parekh, and the title that I have is of Miss Teen Universe India 2021. What is the main quality for Miss Teen Diva? So again, because it's a teen pageant, they want you to be yourself, and they're not looking for picture perfect models to come in. They're looking for girls that they will be able to groom and create the best of themselves. So don't, you know, come there trying to be pretentious or anything. The key is to be yourself and is to have a lot of fun. And I think that is the one quality you need as a Miss Teen Diva. What are the portfolio requirements? So there are no portfolio requirements per se, you can use normal photographs that you've clicked at home by your normal phone camera to register. Like I said, they're not looking for girls that are picture perfect. They're looking for girls that they can actually make into the best versions. How do you decide whether or not you are doing this and this is what you're made for? It's difficult to know such scale, measure, or hard work. Okay, so with me, honestly, my entry into this field was done with the purpose that I was bullied a lot and I wanted to sort of get away from that mindset. However, if you'd want to know what happens behind the cameras, it is a lot of hard work and a lot of work that goes behind this. It's not that one day you wake up, you pack your bags and leave, and that is how you're going to win this. But there is a lot of practice. You have to prepare for yourself, you have to prepare an introduction, you have to prepare for your Q&A rounds, etc. So there is a lot of preparation, and you will not come to know you're made for this until and unless you don't try it. And honestly, pageants are far more than just competition. It is a lot of fun, and this is something I can promise you that every single person who has been part of this pageant will agree that it is an opportunity of a lifetime. And regardless you want to be part of this field or not, it is something, if you can experience, you should experience. So Siley is joining just in a little bit. She is actually a little occupied with her college work at the moment. So just hold on for just a little while and she'll be here with us on this live. Okay, so Beauty Pageants fan, hi. Thank you so much for asking. I'm doing great. I hope you're also doing wonderful. Like I mentioned, my height is 165 centimeters. Hi Aishwarya. So guys, Aishwarya is our Miss Teen Earth India 2021. So hello beautiful, how are you doing? And she is here on this live all the way from Dubai. Charlie, why is the registration fee so much? You said that it's a national recognized pageant, so don't they get sponsors? Yes, they do get sponsored, and the fee, I will not disagree, is a little bit sometimes for a lot of people to afford. However, it is something that is worth. Once you're in the pageant, you will realize that every single money and anything that you're spending behind the pageant, whether that be time, effort, money, you will find it worth it, because at the end of the day it is one experience. There aren't enough words to describe how beautiful it is. You have other co-winners on this live itself, and I'm pretty sure they'd be able to respond to you in the comments box how wonderful it is, a time to just simply compete, and winning is the latter aspect. So to actually apply for the pageant is free of cost. You don't exactly have a registration fee. You do have a pageant grooming fee, which is of rupees 80,000. So that is something you would have to spend. However, to fill the form and to actually apply is something that you would not have to pay for. Hi Mahi. So I had put a, hi Ritu, how are you doing? I had put a questions box on my story, and I have a couple of questions from there which I will get to answer at the moment. So let's find out. Okay, so somebody had asked me that if their birthday was on 29th April 2001, can they participate in Miss Teen Diva? So unfortunately, you have to be under or 19. Either you have to be 19 or under at the, like, while the competition is going on. So I'm sorry, but you will not be able to participate at Miss Teen Diva. However, you can go for the pageants that are in the adult category, which is GSI, Miss India Petite, etc. So those pageants are still open to you. Okay, so Charlie has asked, financially backward people won't be able to enter, so how is it an inclusive pageant? Only privileged people will be able to pay 75,000. So there is one, a correction. The fee is 80,000 rupees. And also, many don't know this, but Miss Teen Diva actually helps contestants that are not that financially stable to sort of come and participate. So that's not really a thing. We did have a contestant this year also. So it is an inclusive pageant. They will help you come in and they will help you with a lot of things like wardrobe also if you're not able to arrange it for yourself. Okay, so Amaya, you do not have to incur any cost for the international pageant at all. So once you won the nationals, everything from your, you know, wardrobe all the way to your travel and stay and everything is completely compensated and arranged by Miss Teen Diva. Okay, so we finally have Siley with us and I am just going to add her into this.
So we can also have her speak over here.
Right, like Aishwarya mentioned, there is no height criteria for the pageant. And there we have it. We have Miss India, Siley.
How are you, Vachi? I'm so sorry for joining in late. I guess we must have
questions now, right?
There have been a lot of questions, so I've answered as many as I could. So, okay. We have Topic Show, which is asking us in pageant. Hey. They will ask us questions.
All right.
Yes, so we do have a Q&A round. During the finale, and we do have questions asked, and you also have questions asked during your PI, which is your personal interview, which is done with the past year's winners usually, and of course Nikhil sir, who is also our national director. Pageant World India, hi Queens, hello, how are you?
Hello. All right.
What question?
Vachi, you're not audible. I think, Kim, you must be facing some issues because Vachi is audible to me. I can hear you.
Am I audible?
Yeah, yeah, you are. Yeah, Vachi, I can hear you. You're audible.
Voice, like, very,
yeah, yeah, yeah. I can hear it perfectly, to be honest.
Okay, hold on. I will just switch my earphones out in case they have
any sort of...
Sally, you can go ahead and take the questions by then.
Yeah, sure. All right.
Okay, so the one question we have with Siley can answer is, please tell us about the swimsuit round.
Swimsuit round, okay. So during our time, we had a swimsuit suit photo shoot as well as an on-stage round. So those are the two rounds. And I think this yours, Miss Teen Diva, might also have these two rounds. And anything else you want to ask about it? So I'm assuming that you're asking about the two rounds which would be there. So yes, we do have photo shoot as well as an on-stage round shoot. How does the organization guarantee our safety if we participate during... Yes. So this time, the rules have been made that every participant while coming, they'll have to submit a COVID report. Vachi, there's a lot of disturbance on your side. Actually, can't.
Is it better now?
Yeah, it's better. Yeah.
Am I audible now?
Yes, it's audible.
Okay.
Yeah. So, yes, now they would be... and making sure that all the contestants that come in have been tested and are negative before the pageant begins. And along with that, they will also be taking all the precautions to ensure the good health of the participants and to make sure that everyone is healthy during the competition.
All right. So going back, I think, to the swimsuit round, you have the swimsuit round on and off twice, you can say. And that is one that it'll happen for sure, that it'll be your swimsuit photo shoot. And then you can also have it on the day of the finale or in your pre-finale as a walk round. So with us, it happened on the day of the finale, but it is possible that it'll happen in the pre-finale also. So
in the preliminary rounds, yeah.
So that is something you will find out. They tell you, like, when they tell you the whole schedule of the pageant.
Yeah.
If we are not comfortable in exactly swimsuit, is there any other option? So you have to sort of be in swimsuit, that is compulsory, but you do get a choice between a monokini or a bikini. So in case you don't want to wear a two-piece, that is completely up to you.
And also you get to select your own swimsuit. So you can go to the store, try it out and try what style works for you. And if you want to cover some areas, it's all up to you. And you get full freedom to select what you want to wear and something that you're comfortable and confident in.
Thank you so much, Divyanshi. I hope I'm reading your name right. Okay. What is the criteria for winning Miss Teen Diva except money? So, Abhinav, money is actually not the criteria. One way not to win Miss Teen Diva is money. You cannot win the competition. You have two queens sitting in front of you who are saying the same thing. You cannot win just by offering money. That's not an option. But the one way to win it is to perform consistently well throughout the pageant from day one to the very last day. And of course, to have a very good behavior, not just with the team members, but with your co-contestants also. That is equally important.
Interpersonal skills are of utmost importance. And we also have a sub-contest called as Miss Congeniality, on the basis of which they judge you on how you interact with other co-contestants, the crew, and also the people who are not, like, even the hotel staff. It all matters. At the end of the day, it's a beauty pageant, but the way you behave and you treat people around you is also important. And it's one of the most important aspects of being a beauty queen.
Yes. So, Sally, the question to you is, age criteria is up to 19 or before 18?
So, I applied for the pageant when I was 18, but because of the whole COVID scenario, when during the course of the pageant, I was 19 years old and I am 19 right now. So, yes. I think when it comes to application, you can apply up to the age of 19.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. So Euphoria Fest has asked, so you did not pay to win. No, you cannot do that. It's actually illegal to offer money to the organization to crown you. So no, none of us, neither six of us that were crowned that night, have paid to win. We have just put in our hard work into this whole thing to actually come out with the crowns. They don't ask for donations then, and girls winner who makes most donations? No. So you have donations. We actually run with this brand called Keto. And Keto is actually fundraising for underprivileged people. Now, what you will be fundraising for is what the organizers actually decide. For us, it was education. And you fundraise on that. And that has one benefit, is that you get the subtitle of Beauty with a Purpose. And that's just about it. That is where the advantages of raising money actually end. And it is part of social service, which is part of us and our job as being national winners.
And it's not that it's just you who's going to be donating. You have to collect donations. And that is what they emphasize on, that you don't pay. It's on how much you can collect. And it's a donation after all. And it's for a good cause. So it's completely up to you of how much you want to donate and whatever makes you happy. There's no limit to it.
Yes. Okay. So, Sally, the question to you is, what inspired you to go to pageants?
Okay. So I come from a very academically focused background, and pageants, definitely the crowns and the gowns, they always, you know, fascinated me. But I never imagined myself as a winner or participating in a pageant girl, basically. But when I was 17, I decided that I wanted to try out something new and something that would challenge me as a person. And pageants are something that, you know, you need to do a lot of introspection, because when you go there and you're competing with 23 beautiful girls, you do question yourself a lot. Are you good enough? Are you speaking on communication skills good? Do you know how to present yourself and you carry yourself in a room? And I think pageants are all about that. And you cannot perform well in a pageant if you don't know yourself. That's so great. I wanted to go on this journey.
Okay, so I want to ask this question to Siley once, because I think this is a misconception per se. And okay, so I'll ask it in this form. So there's already a question which says, how can I start my journey after 12th with no experience, nothing till now? Okay, so let me tell you all something about Siley, is that she came as a first timer into this pageant and had no previous modeling or pageantry experience per se. So Siley, the question to you is, do you think pageants are solely about looking pretty, or are they far greater than that? And does it matter if you're a first timer in a national level pageant?
All right. So definitely, as Vachi said, that I do not come from a pageantry or modeling background. It was my first time entering this whole industry. So it was a little intimidating, but as I said, you know, you need to know yourself, and as long as you're confident and you believe in yourself, you can achieve whatever you want to. It depends on how you set your goals. So talking about my journey, I did take training just before the pageant to make sure that I don't leave any stone unturned. But even that is not, you know, a compulsion as such, because during the national pageant, right, they judge you on a lot of things, and it's not just the ramp walk. You know, you can improve that later as well. But I would say that that's one of the category that they judge on. It's not just that. Okay. And the communication skills and all, that is something you can build yourself. You can work on your body at home. And there are so many things that you don't need to pay for a coaching or to go some class. I would say it's up to you. If you can afford it, definitely go for it. It does help you a lot. But if you can't, then try to do your best. And then
also, I think I'm sorry, but to add to Siley, if in case you're not able to go to a training institute, Miss Teen Diva does have training classes. Like, we all had training on Zoom for one month before our pageant, which does help you a lot. So, you know, you don't have to be really worried about the whole grooming part. And of course, when you even come there, the previous queens are there and you are open to let them. Like, if you come this year, we'll be there at the pageant to help you with any questions that you may have, you know, throughout the pageant. So, and also we have our Instagrams open to each one of you. So please DM us. We'll be more than happy to help you through that. I try and respond to as many DMs related to the pageant I can. So please go ahead and DM us. Is it compulsory to have a groom section before going to the pageant? Like we mentioned, it's not necessary to have being part of a groomer or any sort of grooming school. You can, if you feel you're good enough to just go by yourself, then you can just go by yourself. Okay. Amaya is asking, when I fill the form, I by mistake clicked on 5'6". When I'm 5'5", is that going to cost me? Okay, Amaya, so I really don't think it's going to cost you, but I believe to be on the safer side, you should just refill the form, put in your correct height, and just submit it with 5'5". So I think Siley's internet is lagging. Guys, is it my internet or is it Siley's internet? Could somebody please verify? Aap apne hair ke liye kya karte ho, Vachi? So I basically and practically live in oil. I oil my hair a lot. I will oil my hair as many times as I can oil my hair in a week. And I will only wash them once they're oiled. So that's basically what I do for my hair. Okay, so Siley is having an internet error. So we will wait for her to come back. Vachi, did you take part in previous year? So I had participated in Miss Teen India 2019. Yes, but this was my first attempt at Miss Teen Diva. Can 16-year-olds be crowned as the queen as well? Or is it preferred? Okay, so now to
cut that confusion, anybody that fits in the age criteria can and will be crowned the queen if they truly deserve it. So Ayushi Dholakia, the queen for Miss Teen International also, she was actually 16 when she won Miss Teen India 2019. So there is no sort of age issue that kind of takes place throughout the pageant. If you're in, then you're at an equal chance of winning. So what inspires me, the one thing that actually inspires me is just the love for the work. I love being and helping people, and that is just something that keeps me going so much. And that is something that I've learned from my mother, is to be helpful at all points in life. And I think this whole community in general gives me the voice to sort of, you know, socially stand and actually make a difference. So that is something that inspires me and keeps me going. So you will actually catch all the Miss Teen Diva winners with Ayushi in the coming week. So don't worry, you'll get a chance to hear from all of them at all times. Are you planning to have a workshop or something for the girls? All right, so actually that's a question from me to you. Do you want a workshop? And I would be happy to conduct it. So we're adding Siley back, and we hope this time it will not.
Hi.
Sorry,
I was facing some internet issues here. Yeah.
Okay, so we have my mom here and she's saying hi, beauties. Hello, mama.
Hello.
Okay, so we have a question which I can give you. Okay, Sally, do you want to do mainstream modeling or acting in the end? So this is a question for both of us. You can answer it first.
All right. So I do have a different current plans. Like, I'm not thinking about getting into modeling as such, but I am open to all opportunities that come my way. It's not that I'm just going to say, if it's a good opportunity and I feel it's given me the right exposure that I need and will help me in my career later, I would definitely be open to taking it. And like what you can come.
Okay. So for me, I am open to everything. Though acting is something I've had a keen interest in since I was a little kid. But modeling is also something that I love doing. So I think if I have both doors open, I'm just going to go in both of them and enjoy. I'm not going to pick one. So yes. Where did you guys buy these clothes for pageant? And most importantly, swimsuit. So for me, I shopped from various places, online, offline, normal stores. My swimsuits, however, were from H&M because they were the most convenient to purchase. And there is another, you can also go to Zivame, which also carries a line of swimsuits. And you can always find Instagram stores that, you know, do sell swimsuits. What about you, Siley?
Yeah, even I got my swimsuits from H&M because they are affordable as well as good quality. So I would highly recommend them. Are you all getting, in case you want to get them from there? And when it came to the other wardrobe, I think, you know, packing for a pageant of 7 days, we had multiple outfits. So as Vachu said, like online, offline stores, it's actually up to you. But when it came to gowns, I would like to address, because gowns do tend to be very expensive. So I chose to rent them and instead of buying them, because they were on the expensive side. But it's up to you. If you can afford to buy gowns, you can do that. If you want to rent them, or you can also get them sponsored by designers who are more than happy to do that for you.
Exactly. Okay, so tell us about the talent round. So talent round, as our national director likes to call it, is a treat to the eyes. It is
absolutely
beautiful to watch. And you are free to perform absolutely anything that you would like under 3 minutes. And if you do have something that will take longer, you can just inform the organization and they'd be happy to extend your time so you can finish your performance. You can do basically anything. You can dance, you can paint, you can absolutely, absolutely anything to your heart's content. You can even perform two things if you'd like. You want to dance and sing together, that is also open to you. Don't you think the swimsuit round was too much considering this pageant concerns minors? Okay, so I think I'd let Siley answer this one because, okay, I think her internet is having an issue. Siley, are you here?
Yeah, actually I can only hear it. Can you?
Yeah, but your voice is breaking.
Yeah, is it better now?
Yes. Great. So yeah. The question is, you think the swimsuit round was too much considering this pageant concerns minors?
Mm-hmm. All right. So this pageant was the first time I ever wore a two-piece. I must say that the whole environment of the pageant is so, you know, you don't feel that you're vulnerable. Definitely depends up to you. But I did not feel that I was put into any uncomfortable situation or position. I was very comfortable wearing. The crew members made sure that you're comfortable. And see, I don't feel, at the end of the day, the whole idea behind pageants is being confident about your body, right? And it's not that if you're minors, you're not supposed to wear. I genuinely don't see any problem when it comes to swimsuit. I think it's just another piece of clothing. And maybe because we are in India, there's some stereotype about it, and I get your concerns and where you're coming from. Even I come from a very conservative background, but I don't think that that is something you should really stress about. Yeah, Bachi, if you want to go ahead. Yeah.
Also, adding on to that, swimsuits, you get to purchase your own. So you don't, like, you know, you can go and find a swimsuit that is to your comfort with a higher coverage.
Higher coverage.
And also the thing is, yes. And also the thing is, you are being asked to wear a swimsuit because it's part of all of the international pageants that take place. So what would be sort of more uncomfortable is that you don't have any sort of comfort with yourself in a swimsuit. And suddenly when you go ahead to an international, which is another great deal to actually wear India across your chest. And at that point, they want you to be pre-prepared and comfortable. And the best way to do that is to practice. So that will only come when you will be practicing in your nationals. So that's what's with swimsuit. Okay. No, there is no height criteria for Miss Teen Diva. So no matter how tall or short you are, it does not matter. There was another question which I saw. Okay. Which is the most important round? So according to me, personally, I would say that the whole pageant, you need to be consistent. You cannot decide that, oh, okay, I'm going to do my ramp walk properly and that is what is going to cause me to win. Though I would say that personal interview is something that does carry a lot of weightage when it comes to the overall calculation of you winning.
Definitely. When it comes to pageants, consistency is the key. You need to make sure that you're performing your best at every round.
Indeed. Okay, so Charlie, when I say all international pageants, I am not talking about Miss World, etc. I am speaking about the four international pageants that the four Miss Teen Diva Queens actually go ahead to represent. And each four of them does have a swimsuit round. Hence, you need practice in your nationals with them. On what basis all the six winners were selected for each different title? Go ahead, Sally.
Yeah. So I would say that each title has some kind of motto behind it. When it comes to Miss Teen International, we say that it's beauty with purpose. So it only made sense that Roshi won because she had raised an enormous amount of around over 5 lakhs, right? And because she's also associated with wonderful NGOs and she does so much of philanthropic work, it was totally deserving of her to win that. Coming to Universe, I think Universe is being confidently beautiful and it's Vachi and you can like see her, like it made sense. So when When it came to Earth, Aishwarya was engaging in a lot of activities which were related to environment. She went for cleanliness drive. She collected over, I guess, 25 kilos of plastic waste.
In fact, 100
and,
kilos, as far as I remember. She was supposed to
I guess the challenge
kg.
Was 25, yeah.
Yes,
yeah.
And she ended up collecting 100 kgs. So
over
100,
yeah.
Huge.
And I'm very comfortable
with multinational.
Okay,
yes.
Yeah.
So with multinational, Siley here. So multinational is actually all about beauty with brains. And Siley here was the winner of our sub-contest. And she is truly beauty with brains. I mean, come on, she's an engineer in the making. So you do expect a lot of brains to be involved. And so, yes, she is A, very beautiful, B, very confident, and C, extremely smart. And now, because multinational is beauty with brains, it does not mean that the remaining two and three girls are not competent.
Not
they
exactly.
are ready. But there are different judging criteria that sort of put in each girl to every place.
Yeah.
Yes, so Aishwarya has confirmed it was 100 kgs. We're proud of you, Aishwarya.
Thank you.
Okay, are we all known in advance about what all rounds would be there? For example, swimsuit round. Do we get to know everything on spot? Okay, so the pageant will actually send you either a PDF document or a PPT or an email, either one of those three, explaining to you what you need to carry for the pageant. And during your Zoom meetings, you will be notified on what things will take place roughly in what, manner throughout the pageant, like in what order will they be taking place. So yes, you do get to know because you have to be pre-informed and you will have to carry your wardrobe accordingly.
And they also specify the number of items you need to carry. Like if you want to, the number of swimsuit in case you need one for the ramp and one for the shoot,
they will
exactly
specify you need two.
Yeah, they will specify everything.
Okay, so Abhinav is asked that she, in terms of Rashi, won because she raised the most money. No, Siley was just giving an example.
Example, yeah.
She was the Beauty with a Purpose winner. The advantage that our pageant had with Beauty with a Purpose is that once you win the subtitle, you're fast-tracked into the top eight. Beyond that, it is on everyone's... Once you reach top eight, you are at neutral. Everyone is at 0.0. And depending on how you answer and what characteristics you've carried throughout the pageant is what decides how you win and what title you win.
And once you reach the top eight, it's all upon how you answer your final question. I think that is the deciding criteria along with... I think once you reach on the top eight level, we are all equal and all of us stand an equal chance at winning the crowns.
Okay. So now, GK World, yes, you had asked me that your birthday is 29th April 2001. I am sorry to inform you that you will be a little older, a year older by the time the pageant will happen. But don't be disheartened. There are multiple other pageants that the Glamland family in general conducts. So please go ahead and apply for one of those. Okay, so now we have another question. How many subtitles are there and how many rounds are there? Go ahead.
Yeah, so there are 22 subtitles or sub-contests that take place. I'll give you a few examples. Like there was Fitness, Miss Iron Maiden, then Beauty with Brains. We also had Best in Speech. So there are various parameters, 22 and exact, to on which they judge you. And these are held over the span of the 7 days that of the pageant.
Okay.
So you'll get the exact details on Miss Teen Diva's website as well, in case you want to know the... all the subcontests.
Everything. Yes. Also, you can go to Miss Teen Diva's page. They've announced all the subtitle winners. So you'll be able to actually see how many subtitles truly took place, though they can differ from pageant to pageant.
Year to year.
Each edition, they can edit them. So, yes. Also, among six queens, are all equal or they are given titles like first runner, sub second runner? Okay. So we have four main winners, which go ahead to have four titles, which is International, Universe, Earth, and Multinational India. And then we have one first runners-up and we have another second runners-up. So that is how the crowning process works. Okay. Charlie is asking us, what was the final question? The top eight final question.
You want to take this?
Go ahead. Okay. Yeah, all right. That's all right. So the final questions, though I do not remember word by word, but was in something of the lines of that if we had to choose one contemporary woman who has to be... Yes, okay. So Sharia's put the question.
Which contemporary woman do you think is a role model for our generation? That was our top 8 final Q&A. And that's a common question answer round. So all 8 girls are put backstage in a room with very loud music, so we cannot hear anything that's happening outside. And we go one by one and we give the answer to the very same question so that the judgment can be as fair as it can get. Okay. Those contestants who do not win the contest, what else do they get from being part of it?
I would say the biggest gift or advantage of participating in a pageant, in, even if you don't win, is the experience of being there. Along with all the grooming that you go through, you come out as a better person, you know yourself better, and as a polished person as well. And you make a lot of friends. We had a gala time, to be honest. Like, I think Vachi would agree on that. And
oh,
it's
yes.
a lot of memories. Okay. Oh, and I think there's no losing when it comes to pageants.
And apart from that, you become part of the Glamelan family and you're going to get invited
exactly.
to every other pageant that they, you know, sort of like take place. Like right now, GSI will happen. Then we will have other multiple pageants that Glamelan will conduct. So you get invited. You also get opportunities. It's not that
opportunities yes.
from the thing is limited only to the winners. Everybody gets those opportunities. Somebody is wishing us luck for our international pageants. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Okay, Abhinav has said organizations should do a live of the pageant finale so audience can see whose answer was the actual best and disclose the marks of the contestants like Miss Universe. So Abhinav, in fact, they are planning to go live in the next edition of Miss Teen Diva. So I think you will be able to watch and see and you'll know that the judgment of the organization is correct every single time.
And also, if you want to know the answers of the current winners and the other contestants, they'll also be uploaded on YouTube and on Miss Teen Diva's page. So
just
stay
keep
tuned
waiting.
For it.
Yes, you will get them very, very soon. What is GSI? GSI is Glamelan Supermodel India. It is the Miss Category pageant, which leads to Miss International and
Miss Multinational.
Miss Multinational. So those you can go to when you are 18 and above. Okay, the local Kalakar, hello. What do you think will be new in the next edition of Miss Teen Diva? Well, let's leave that a surprise, though we do have a slight idea. But once the girls will be disclosed, you will also all come to know what are the new things that will happen. So yes, but it's going to be full of fun, excitement, and just playing an experience that's irreplaceable. How much time will this whole session take? So, in fact, it's just going to go about for another 10 to 15 minutes. So, whatever questions you have, please go ahead and shoot them out right now so we can answer them as soon as possible.
Yeah.
Abhinav, Vachi, I like your public speaking skills. Thank you so much.
So do I.
Okay. Well, we are now... Sally, you got some questions in the question box that you had put up on your story.
Yeah.
So,
just going through the questions.
Okay, so Yukta Thakur has asked, do you all pay the fee before the Zoom classes? We'll answer that. Sally, you're lagging.
Hello? Yeah. Am I still lagging? Oh God, I'm facing really bad internet issues
today. It's fine now. Okay. Did y'all pay the fee before Zoom classes started? So I'm aware that a lot of contestants paid the fees in two halves. So it became simpler to also actually pay the amount. So yes, you can pay it in two halves and those details are actually with the organization. So you should directly contact them to get further insights on those. When will they disclose the final participants and when will the finals in which month approximately? So Shelly,
again...
Yeah,
I think the organization will be able to help you better when it comes to these kind of questions because at the end of the day, they control the entire flow of the pageant and along with the contestants and the dates. So feel free to DM them on the Instagram page or you can also mail them. They are a very good organization and they'll get back to you as soon as possible.
Was it very hectic with the back-to-back schedule for 7 days of the pageant? Okay, So now it's undeniable, the fact that yes, it will be hectic. That is something you need to mentally prepare yourself for, that you will have to sort of manage your days around. And but again, it's the fun kind of hectic. Imagine having 20 other girls that are the same aim and are very similar around the same age criteria. Imagine the amount of fun there is. So it's actually less pressure, more fun when it comes to being a back-to-back schedule.
And even the subcontests are fun, right? I don't feel like even there was no pressure as such, like maybe inside, but we were all in the moment and we were enjoying ourselves. And I think that was the greatest memory I took back from the pageant.
Okay, so there is no height criteria for Miss Teen Divas. So you don't have to be a particular height in order to participate. Sally, what is your height?
Your height. So I am 5 feet 3 inches tall. I think that explains that there is no height criteria.
There is no height criteria. Exactly. Yeah. So now there is somebody asking, if you're not able to pay the fee, there is another option. Okay, so I had mentioned this in the initial half of the life as well. So the organization is actually very considerate about contestants and participants that may not be able to afford it. So you can actually contact them again. They are the best people to tell you in exact details what will be, the process for that. So please go ahead and actually DM them or email them and you'll get a reply. Okay. I did DM them and email them, but they are not replying. I'm worried what to do with my registration. All right. So either you can try and refill your form and register, or you can just DM them on Instagram again and be a little patient with their replies. They're trying to get back to as many people as they can. For activewear, can we wear a sports t-shirt? Yes, you can.
Yeah.
What is my height? I am 165 centimeters tall. Okay. Miss Teen Diva is not a month-long process. So the question is, this Miss Teen Diva contest take place in how many months?
How many months?
So the coming edition will be about 9 to 10 days. And for more details about dates and venue, you will have to wait and keep following Miss Teen Diva.
But yes, once you get selected as a contestant, there is a month-long training period in which you get a lot of trainers who come and train you on the basis of, I think, communication skills. We had GK, we had mock personal interviews as well. So that takes a month.
Okay, Sally, you're going to get a text in your inbox. Please reply.
All right.
Okay, so we had both put question box on our stories and we had a couple of questions, which I think we can now get to. Okay, so the one most relevant question I feel that should be addressed here is, the question was, are there any makeup artists throughout the pageant to help you, or do you have to do it yourself?
All right, so do you mind if I take it?
Go ahead.
Yeah, so you have makeup and hair. You can get your hair done by professionals. Okay. So there are makeup artists and hair artists do for the shoots, but on the other subcontests and the finale. But when it comes to other, subcontests that take place, then you have to do your own hair and makeup. There you do not get professionals. But again, as Vachi said, for the finale, you do have a team that comes and does the hair and makeup for you.
Yes. And also, even if, for example, you're not comfortable with the professional artist doing your hair and makeup, yeah, you can politely ask the organization to give you the permission to do your own hair and makeup also. So it's really not a mandate.
That's not a compulsion. Yeah. Yes. Whatever you're comfortable with.
Two winners can be from the same place as well. Yes, in fact, we have Sally and Rashi both from Mumbai. So I think that very clearly answers your question that yes, there can be two winners from the same place. Okay, Sally, the question is to you. How did you manage your studies along with the competition?
Okay, so I would say during the training period, definitely I had to manage my time very wisely. I had to set my priorities, I have to say, I was seeing. It all depends on what you're aiming for. Studies were important for me, but I knew that this is something I want to achieve and I need to put in extra hours for it. I did not let it affect my studies, and I think if I can do it, you can do it too. You just need to put in all the effort that you can, and maybe a few sleepless nights would help you achieve a crown one day.
Yes. Also, Shelly, yes, I do remember you had DM'd me. I have forwarded your details and information to the organization, so please don't be worried. You will hear from them very, very soon. Okay. So, Sally, I'm sure even you had a bunch of questions that people had sort of asked in your story.
Yeah, one of the questions I found really interesting was how to prepare for an on-stage question. Do you want to take it?
All right. So now on-stage question and answers, to me personally, I feel is the scariest part of the pageant, because you do not get any prior information on what the question is going to be or from what category, in fact, it is going to come. So you have to sort of be... to an extent, be all round aware of what is happening, right, from GK, national, international affairs, and also a lot of things in general. Usually those questions are opinion related and they want to know what you feel about a certain matter. So the one way to prepare is that you can go ahead and Google, and you will find lists of thousands and thousands of pageant questions which you can take and practice maybe 5 or 10 each day. So you will get into the habit and your brain will get into the habit of thinking on spot. So that's how I practiced, and I feel that sort of worked with me.
And I would say, adding to what Vashi said, definitely as she said, that you need to be very updated related to current affairs. You need to know what's going on in the world. And also I would say, along with, I would say, answer the questions very honestly, okay? Because as you're getting a question on the spot, you get hardly get any time, and avoid memorizing an answer and speaking it on stage, because the judges can catch that very easily. Speak your heart out and say something that you really believe in, and I think that is the way that you can prove your authenticity and show, like, stand out from the crowd.
Okay, so Seema, or I'm sorry if I'm reading your name wrong, does the question repeat each year, or there used to be a new question every year? The question will not repeat. Let me just tell you this much. It will not. I am saying this. It's not going to repeat, at least not in the near future. So please be prepared for something completely out of the box thrown at you. So again, practice is what is going to get you to answer well. So we'll take last two questions and then we will call an end to this live. So we're waiting. Any two questions that come up, we will be happy to respond to them. Till we're waiting for two questions to come, I have another question over here, which is, good skincare products which are not too costly. So now, skincare again is something that is very personal and very, very subjective.
Subjective, so yeah.
If you can, please go ahead and consult a dermatologist in case you have a skin issue or something. If not, then please use a regular face wash and a regular face moisturizer and a body moisturizer, and that's all you need for skincare. Okay, so we have...
There's one question I would like to answer. Knowing fluent English is compulsory? No, it is not. It's not compulsory, but definitely it gives you an edge, because when you will be going for your international pageants, you won't need a translator and you'll be able to express your thoughts when it comes to answering questions, and in your PI, it does give you a leverage over there, because, you know, sometimes the feelings get lost in translation, but it's not compulsory.
It is not compulsory and it's not going to cause you a loss. That is for a fact.
Yeah.
At Miss Teen Diva, at least in the national finale, you are allowed to give your answer in either Hindi or English, whichever one you find more comfortable. And just because you're speaking in Hindi will not take away your opportunity from winning the crown. It will absolutely not do that. Okay, on which basis all the contestants get marked? So that is, to be honest, a question we have with our own self. The organization is marking you 24/7. It's not limited to just the sub-contest or just the finale. And you will not know when you're being judged, so that they can judge you at your most candid moments.
And let me say, I remember Nicholson telling us that he will also judge us on the basis of how we come down and dressed for breakfast. So you need to be presentable even if it's 8 in the morning, or we had sessions going on till 3 a.m. So you need to be presentable all the time.
Right. So again, just to sum this all up, we hope that you have gotten all your answers. There is one last question which I feel is important. Is it necessary to wear heels of 4 to 5 inches and pencil heel? Yes, unfortunately, it is, because that is what pageant standards internationally also require you to wear. So yes, a 4 to 5 inch, a proper stiletto heel is compulsory. So
and only stilettos, no block heels, no wedges.
Also, the reason strictly why pencil they heels. Say the reason why we sort of stray away from wearing block and wedges is because it does affect your walk, because those heels are heavier on your feet, so you will lose your balance throughout your walking. So please try and get a proper heel, a proper pageant heel. If you don't know how to buy one, or you don't know which one to buy, our DMs are open to help you all. And we will be happy. I will be happy, and I'm sure Saili will be happy to assist you in all of that. All right. So I think we have officially come to the end of this live, and we hope that you've had a good time and most of your questions have been answered. And in case they haven't been, we're all also going to come live with Miss Teen International, that is Ayushi Dholakia, from this very week. So be hold and be prepared for that one as well. Keep your questions.
Looking forward to seeing all there. And yes, as she said, and if you don't, if you feel that you can't wait, then you can always hit us up in our DMs. We'll be very happy to answer them even there. And I think many of you all asked questions which were more related to the organization. Again, I would say, please feel free to contact them. They will reach out to you. And as there's many of you all, please be patient as well. But yes, definitely they will get to answer all your questions.